something I don't like here at all. See now, something I don't like here at all. Why are we descending? I mean, why are we descending? And we are descending badly. What is wrong here? Autopilot is engaged immediately. Out of nothing. Yeah, this cannot be a wave point. I have the control right now. Something went wrong here. Let us forget the vertical speed at the moment. No. Something is wrong here. And we are banking. Let me have a look at the flight plan. Something I don't like here. How can we fix this one? Okay, first we must stabilize the plane. Here we have an emergency right now. Altitude, flitch immediately, flitch to keep our current altitude, flitch on. Okay, flitch on. Let us stabilize at 15. Let us forget the lateral navigation. Let us go back to vertical navigation. I don't know what is going on, I mean, but I must find out. Okay, with flitch mode we stabilized. Let us go back to altitude mode, vertical speed. Something is terribly wrong. I mean, we continue banking. Okay, heading mode. No. I will disconnect again the autopilot. And I will disconnect the auto throttle. We have an emergency. Okay, I have the control of the plane. Fuel we have, isn't it? 45%. I don't know. Let us climb again. Let us climb manually, actually. I don't know what is going on right now. Anyhow, it is not the first time. And you know, I was trying to find the song on YouTube, actually, when all these bad things happened. So, again. I hope we are climbing to 15,000 feet right now. Yeah, so it seems. XTK-20, we are cross track distances. This, we are 20 miles, we deviated 20 miles from our flight plan. This cannot go on like this. Wait. I really don't know. And why the center didn't inform us about it, that we deviated. So heading mode, which is on, and little by little let us turn again. Shift H. Okay, we turn. Good. We climb to 15,000 feet. Auto throttle is manual at the moment. And we will go back to our route somehow. 25 miles we deviated. XTK, cross track distance, this one. And this happened when I went to YouTube to find the song. And I have showed also these things lots of times. Actually, you know, I can as well turn the plane when I leave the cockpit. For instance, let's say okay, let us go east, which means 90. So have a look here. Please, don't want this camera, I want the other one. This, or this one. So, CTRL, I press CTRL and DEL. Have a look here, have a look here. 90, little by little, otherwise you may have a crash. Yeah, otherwise you may have a crash. And little by little we turn. Okay, can be as well 120. We are just trying to go back to our flight plan, you see. Here it is. The cameras, alt zero. Yeah, these are very nice, alt 9, the saved cameras. These three actually. So now I can bring as well the VFR map. 15,000 feet, we stabilized again. And okay, we will go back to our course and we'll try to return to navigation mode, nav mode, isn't it? Alt 9. What is this? Overspeed. Overspeed. Overspeed means speed brakes immediately. Immediately speed brakes. Okay. Overspeed is above 360 something knots. Okay. Anyhow, we are going little by little back to our flight plan. I will climb. I don't want the clouds right now. Let's say CTRL page up. So I am afraid we must climb. Let me see if auto throttle works now. Okay. Yeah, it seems it works. Speed again, CTRL shift and 300. 320. See, out of nowhere, all these problems appeared. 325. Okay, 25. CTRL, shift, and insert. There is a tutorial about these things. Okay. So, altitude again 20. CTRL page up. Okay, vertical speed plus 2000 quickly. And I hope we will stabilize now at 20,000 feet with a vertical speed of plus 2000 feet, a rate of ascent actually. And I think the situation is again under control. Let us have a look at the flight plan. Let us wait to find our way and then we will turn again to nav mode, lateral navigation mode. Let us make it 25. 25. I want something more secure. 25, yes. I wonder why the center didn't complain so far. 24, okay. So we're climbing. It would be interesting to see the windows. Okay. You see, for instance, these strange things. Vertical speed, I have said, I mean. I have fucking said the vertical speed, 2000. Sometimes your settings change and you always monitor the instruments. Which was the squawk? 6312. You see, okay.
Air China 9699 radar contact 19 miles southwest of Uniform Kilo Lima Zulu flight level 210.
Call center Air China 96999, 18 miles northwest of Lima Romeo Foxtrot Romeo, request IFR to Ben Gurion, ready to copy.
Okay.
Continue to pilot turning and following heading 120 descent and maintain 13,000 feet.
13,000 feet, we are climbing to 24, so I need 11,000 feet. Acknowledge first.
Pilot turning and following heading 120, descend and maintain 13,000 feet Air China 96999.
And then 3 on the keyboard. 9.
VOF Center Air China 96999. Request flight level 215.
And then we will go to 24,000 feet, okay. Weather, however, changed. 1.75, what was it? 118.175. Let me have a look. 118.175. 118.75. Change the frequency manually. That is what I wanted to show you. 0071. 0071.
Air China 96999, did you hear my last transmission?
Zero. How do I change this? 071.
Air China 96999 radar contact.
You see?
0 miles southeast of Lima Romeo.
Please, somehow, okay. Learn a few things, please, okay? I mean, you see a few things now. What to do, just to hear music and to see the clouds. This is the way how you set squawk code and the frequency manually. So, and I want another 2,000 feet. Okay. Acknowledge.
Roger Air China, 96999.
Soon she will complain about our altitude. I think we are 2,000 feet above. Okay, wonderful clouds, however. It starts to be a little bit frustrating. And I wanted to hear a song, you see. I wanted to hear a song. Can I? Okay, I will change the frequency if we hear a song, because otherwise it can be annoying. 1175. Let us change this one. Okay, we got rid of the center. And I want to hear my song finally. And I want it loud. And then I will leave the plane on autopilot and we'll continue later.
Understand.
something is missing. Hope something bad will not happen again. Wonderful clouds. So I just want to go back on course and okay, navigation mode now. Okay, let us see the big moment. I hope we will be on course finally. I hope so. I hope we will be back on course after all these problems. The wonderful cameras of Captain Sim, those are the saved ones. It took quite some time to go back on course, and I see that the lights are automatically activated here, so that means that later I must arrange my lights. You see, little by little we will find our route again. I don't know what happened earlier. I mean, I really don't know, but it is not the first time. These things happen from time to time. Ah, it seems we are turning again. Let us have a look, let us have a look. I hope nothing bad will happen again. Okay, good, excellent. 24,000 feet finally, and we are back on course since. Good. Yeah, good. We managed somehow. And you can see the same things here, of course. Here I have maximum range of 320 miles. Here it is. Distance 120 miles until our next wave point. Okay, everything is just fine. Okay, excellent. We are back on course. It's getting darker. Okay, shall we arrange the lights a little bit now? I think it is a little bit better. Okay, anyhow.
Air China 906 909 radar contact.
this LRCK must be Constanta, Romania. If we type Constanta, I hope it works. We are somewhere here right now. So soon we will be above the Black Sea. Then Turkey. Somewhere here we go. This is our route. And we departed where from? Somewhere here, I think. Here it is, Kaliningrad. We departed from Kaliningrad, isn't it? Anyhow, just have a look where is the plane right now. I will try to use time acceleration and to cross the Black Sea. You see? So now I suppose we are above Turkey and we will be for quite some time. Maybe now I can use time acceleration until the next waypoint, which is this, but no. Yeah, it is another 400 miles. Never mind. Soon we will be at Batno. Somewhere here. And then it is Cyprus. Mediterranean Sea. We fly above Cyprus for sure. And then there is still quite some time for this journey, for this flight. Whatever I tell you here, I must follow also, and I always used to say that it is good to save your flight from time to time. Now I haven't saved my flight at all. That means that if we have a crash, it is bye-bye. So in order to save your flight, I can go here and I start recording a little bit. Record a little bit, not much. Stop recording, save. Here are some saved flights, actually some saved landings. And let us write, for instance, Tel Aviv. Okay, save. Now it is saved. Okay, so if I go to load, we see somewhere here is Tel Aviv. So if something happens, at least I can load this recording, this short recording, and I can find myself, let's say, where we are right now. It is good to save your flights from time to time, otherwise you may as well lose your flights. Maybe visibility helps also. Weather became better again, real time, real weather. I will try to find my next waypoint, which is this Batno, and then we will be above Mediterranean Sea. Good. Okay, you can see right now that I use again time acceleration, isn't it? The airplane moves much more faster on the map. If you see, for instance, here, our fuel is reduced, isn't it? 39% right now. So soon we will be above Mediterranean Sea, and afterwards we will fly above Cyprus, as far as I can see here, isn't it? We are close to our next waypoint, about 25 miles, this Batno, and let us descend a little bit, let us descend to 20,000. Okay, let us. I'm sure that you know these things how to do. Let us choose the easy way. CTRL and page down. Okay. Let us reduce our speed, because otherwise we may have an overspeed. So, CTRL, Shift and Del. We will accelerate anyways, and let's say, a decent rate of descent, as I used to say, of about 1,000 to 3,000 feet. Good, good, good. About rate of descent and rate of ascent, I insist a little bit, because I think that everything above, let's say, 2,000, maximum 2.5 feet per minute, it is a little bit inconvenient. And as I said lots of times, okay, you see on the FMC, you can see values like 6,000-7,000, and okay, what to say. It is good to have your passengers feeling comfortable. We are getting closer, and next wave point, Merva something. Yeah, indeed, here it is. And I would like to show you something interesting. Okay, let us try to make it simple, because my calculations may be wrong. Our next wave point is this Merva. We are about 170 miles far from Merva. Okay. Now remember this one, that when we will reach Merva, that means when the distance here will be zero, isn't it? And then we go to Topuz, I suppose, which is maybe our last wave point. So when we will reach Merva here, course is 150. Okay, here is more or less 150. Yes, course here, you see 150, it is correct. So when we will reach this Merva, I want to have an altitude of 10,000 feet. Okay, that means that I must lose 10,000 feet, from 20,000 to descend to 10,000. So which is the TOD if I want to lose 10,000 feet? The top of descent, I mean. It is 10,000 feet multiplied with 3 times 10,000 feet, that makes 30,000 feet, divided with 1,000, that means 30. So when here will be 30 miles far from Merva, okay, when we will see here 30, must be our top of descent, and we must start descending. In order to reach Merva with an altitude of 10,000 feet instead of 20. So in order to reach Merva with an altitude of 10,000 feet, more or less, which one must be our descent rate? Our descent rate must be our speed, this one here, 300, 5 times, that makes 1.5, isn't it? 1.5, 1,500 feet per minute. So this is exactly what we will do. So now it is interesting, have a look. We are 33 miles far from Merva. Okay, not too much precision, 10,000 feet. Okay, we set the rate of descent of 1,500 feet, but in order to be sure, okay, so in order to be sure, I put a rate of descent of 1.7, 1.6 or 1.7. 1.65. And that's all. So, the point is now to see if when we will reach Merva with these calculations, and by the way, our speed is accelerating, maybe to reduce it a little bit, because we need a constant speed of 300, which actually is not possible. I pressed speed brakes actually. Okay. So let us see if we reach Melva, how close we will be to about, let's say, 10,000 feet, according to our calculations. And of course, we are much more closer now. And after Merva, we have this Tapuz here, and we must set an arrival and so on. I'm really curious if it will work or not. Of course, I can as well have a look continuously here, isn't it? I mean, to see. Now, for instance, we are going to 17, 25 miles far. According to these calculations, when we will reach Merva, we want to have an altitude of 10,000 feet. We want to lose actually 10,000 feet. And that's why we are descending from 20,000 to 10,000. Thought was 10,000 three times 30,000 divided with 1,000, that makes 30, isn't it? And if somehow getting closer to Merva, I see that okay, we will not make it, I can increase the rate of descent, isn't it? Don't forget that this rate of descent is not the calculated one, which was 1.5, but 1.65,000 feet per minute rate of descent. It cannot be exactly, let's say, when we will see here zero. I repeat once again that the rate of descent is our speed, 300. You see here exactly 300. We keep an eye on our speed because maybe our speed will increase. We are descending, don't forget. Let's say approximately can be 5 miles difference. 12 miles now here, this one. Here exactly. Yeah, surprisingly our speed is just fine. I hope I don't have the speed brakes, and I cannot see very well actually right now. Let me have a look. Yeah, not. Here are the speed brakes. 8 miles, and we are descending from 14,000 feet. 4 or 5 miles, it is just fine. Okay, a deviation. 4 or 5 miles. Slightly, I will increase the descent rate slightly, let's say to 1.8,000 feet. But anyhow, I just showed you how you can approximately calculate your rate of descent. Actually, your top of descent, and afterwards your rate of descent. Yes, there was a deviation, of course. I mean, there is a deviation. We already passed this Merva wave point. And so, now, about our runway. Runway, I want 08, frequency we set 110.90, elevation 124 feet, CTRL 4, route, departure, arrival, I want 08 ILS. Yeah, transition Tapuz indeed, is correct. Execute. Let me see now. Let me see. And when we will reach Tapuz, according to our flight plan that changed, Yeah, we must have an altitude of 3,000 feet. So let us descend. How far is this Tapuz? Ah, only 37 miles. So Tel Aviv Center, okay.
Tel Aviv Center, Air China, Niner, 6-Niner, Niner, 9,500 feet.
Air China, Niner, 6-Niner, Niner, Tel Aviv Center Altimeter, 2-Niner.73. Continue to Tapuz as planned.
Good, you see. Now I would prefer slightly darker for the landing. Okay, let us increase the range here. Okay, 40 miles. I cannot see the speed brakes. Can I see them by a camera, something? Yeah, they are set here, you see. Okay. So I disengaged the auto throttle because I didn't like my speed was too high. No, auto throttle is off. Yeah, it is. So we reached 3,000 feet, and since I have the screen mode, let us... Okay, where is this thing? The ground warning proximity system or decision height shows on. Okay. So yes, I hope this is visible right now. No, I don't want to, 26. I acknowledge, but I will land runway 08. When you bring the PFD, the primary flight display, okay, you can have a look what is going on with the ILS guidance. I mean, your glide slope and your localizer. And also, mostly, you see your real elevation, I mean above the ground, your real altitude when you are below 2,500 feet. Always use the PFD map with you bring the PFD map with the, with alt plus mouse click here. Okay, so we are with her. Monitor continuously our instruments, otherwise we may have a surprise. Altitude 3,000 indeed, a speed of 260, first set of flaps, yeah, 3,200 feet. See, glide slope appeared surprisingly. Glide slope appeared. If we turn, maybe localizer will also appear. Here it is, the pink diamond. Gear down. Okay, so I have the runway in sight, of course. Both appeared, localizer and glide slope. So I turn to approach mode, here it is.
Good day.
And flaps. Let me see the wind. Okay, normal things. Flaps 15 even. And soon we will disconnect. Yeah, everything is just fine.
121.4 for United 9055.
So we go to land, isn't it? You see, now we turn to approach mode. Approach mode is on because we have both localizer exactly in the middle and the glide slope. glide slope disappeared. Okay, I will disengage the autopilot. Runway 08, elevation 124. Someone else is landing also. You see here it is. This is all about. Here is your real altitude. 1.8 soon, 2000 feet. A little bit. Speed brakes. I cannot retract my stupid speed brakes. Okay, autopilot is disengaged. I armed the speed brakes this time, though I shouldn't. Speed brakes don't work, unfortunately. So to arm them again. Okay. Why don't hear any warning? Yes, I know.
Clear the runway.
I wonder if speed brakes are armed. I really wonder. Okay. You see, they're fucking stuck. They're fucking stuck. The lever, I mean. I will check this out.
You were not clear to land.
Yeah. Yeah, I cannot, you see, I cannot retract the speed brakes. I mean, I cannot. Because there are always malfunctions. Here it is. Yeah, it doesn't work. Slash doesn't work. Okay. I will exit the runway. As soon as I got out of the runway, ATC service is terminated, which means that, anyhow, that maybe we cannot have a guidance until the terminal. So, speed brakes, no, parking brakes. Okay, at least parking brakes works. Yeah, speed brakes doesn't work. Unbelievable. It doesn't work. I mean, it doesn't work. It doesn't work on the joystick. It doesn't work with the slash command. Anyhow, let us see the landing. What happened here? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Ben Gurion Airport. Welcome to Tel Aviv. Welcome to Israel. Okay, we were not perfectly lined up, but still it is a landing with a touchdown about, let's say, less than 100 feet per minute rate of descent, which is considered, of course, I think, excellent. Let us have a look, and we will, I will not insist, I mean, it was quite annoying, the end, again. Okay, and then I will change the mode from the screen mode. It looks a little bit scary again. But somehow, if we have a look here, this monster, have a look. 5, 10, unbelievable values. Yeah, 115. Perfection. Not perfectly lined up, but of course, okay, this plane, how to say, I think at least it is reliable. The Dreamliner was not, lately was not reliable, at least my sweet baby, this Air China beauty, I love China, the winner of the contest, 2 times appeared too, and she won the contest. This beauty here, she did excellent, yes, under difficult circumstances. Okay, we'll change the time soon. So let us have a break and we will continue. I changed the time, late evening, I mean a few hours earlier, just to have a look at all these things. Hopefully speed brakes were armed and they were activated. Hopefully. /166. /162. Yes, about 100, 115. This runway, I remember, for some reason, always, somehow it is a little bit narrow. Something like this. thank you for watching this clip. Welcome to Tel Aviv, and hope to see you soon to the next one. You take care and bye for now.